I'm so sick right now.
Oh, hi, I'm Get Leveled. And there's something that I find myself wanting to do more and more during my live streams, but there are so many different answers when I look up how to do it. And that thing is that. Oh, you wanna see my plaque?
Let's go.
I can just bring you with me and I still have the microphone working. And there it is, right there. You can see my YouTube plaque. And then I can go back to my desk and just continue my live stream as if nothing happened.
Now, the specific use case here is to not have a whole different setup. It's basically to use any device that has a mic, a camera, an internet connection in your home to show something for a couple of minutes or to bring you along if you're gonna do another activity that is not in front of your desk. Anyways, the method that I found is pretty simple, but we're gonna get right into that after a quick message from our sponsor.
This portion of the video is sponsored by Owned Pro. Owned Pro is an online service and software created for streamers and designed to jumpstart your streaming career, giving you access to overlays, alerts, and other tools for live streamers. Owned Pro is currently available in over 9 languages, and that includes overlays and alerts, meaning that non-English speaker streamers can easily get started with their customized experience. Owned Pro will also give you access to a Twitch chatbot that will moderate your chat and help you run giveaways. They also help you take a good look at your statistics, give you free panels, and even provide copyright-free music. Owned Pro is currently compatible with YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook. Owned Pro is constantly coming up with new features, but I'll let you check it out at own.gg/getlevelpro. That is own3d.gg/getlevelpro.
All right, so let's say that you are on OBS Studio, for example. This also works with any other broadcasting softwares. You're gonna pull up your device, whatever it is, your tablet, your phone, as long as it has an internet connection, a camera, a mic, if you would like to use the mic. And you're gonna go ahead and you're gonna open up your favorite browser. In my case, it's gonna be Chrome, and you're gonna go to vdo.ninja. For those who are veterans of OBS, you might recall this as being named OBS Ninja. Now it's called video.ninja. Fun fact, if you actually type OBS.ninja, it's gonna bring you to the same website. And you're gonna see a bunch of options, but the one we're interested in right now is to add your camera to OBS. Keep in mind that if you want to use this for anything else, make sure you read all of the information in there. You might find out like some other cool tricks that you can do. But we're gonna click on add your camera to OBS. And of course, it's going to load one of the cameras that I'm using. It could be the back camera, the front camera, it doesn't matter. You just have to pick which one. And then, audio source, if you want to use a Bluetooth headset, whatever you want to do, it's all there. Just pick the right one. There's even digital video effects, which is kind of wild when you think about it. You can have a blurred background, you can have digital green screen, all of the like zoom type of effects that you might have. In my case, for this tutorial, I'm gonna be using the front camera. Depending on your phone, you might have like way less options. I have a bunch of cameras on this phone. And then you can click start. Now what happened is that you are currently broadcasting your phone's camera and microphone to a specific link. All you have to do is get this link into your OBS Studio via a browser source. So I'm gonna go ahead on my phone, I'm gonna copy the link, okay, copy to clipboard, and I'm gonna send it to myself via whatever method you want. I like to go use any social media platforms where I can message myself, and I'll just send the link to myself. I'm gonna do this right now. You could also, of course, manually just type the link. Now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to click on plus in my OBS to add a new source. I'm gonna go to browser, I'm gonna call this phone, and then I'm gonna paste the link. Depending on the settings that you chose before broadcasting, you want to change this. I know it's gonna be 720p, but I'm gonna put 1080. It's the same aspect ratio. All right, one thing that you can choose here is to control audio via OBS. That's gonna give you a slider that appears here. On phone, I hear my Windows is freaking out. I'm gonna click allow access. And on my phone, I'm gonna go back to that browser. Testing, testing. As you can see, what you're hearing is the microphone from my phone. So I can just get up and go do stuff around my place and I have my camera. Now, if I wanna turn it off, all I have to do is just click here, boom, and then it's turned off. And I can, I turned that mic back on. And then I can just resume my normal activities. So if I wanna be like, oh, you guys wanna see this thing, let me just bring my phone with me, boom, and I'm able to show stuff to you. I'm in portrait mode, but of course I can do it like that. For example, now I restarted it, it created a new link. It might be a little annoying, but the truth is, it's just a couple of letters and numbers. I'm just gonna type my link right now. it is case sensitive. So it's like 7 letters. Okay. So it seems to only want to be in portrait mode, but if you want to flip it, you can just right click on it, go ahead on transform and rotate 90 degrees. There you go. And now I have it landscape mode. In that case, maybe double clicking and switching out the values here will give you a better control. There you go. Now I can easily just place this and the whole difference. And the quality isn't like super, super sharp. That mostly has to do with the internet connection. I am on a very, very bad internet connection. So the better your internet connection, the lower the delay and the sharper the quality. But it's just like a cool little thing that you can just grab, walk around your place, go show some stuff and then come back. If you don't want the audio, that's completely fine. If you want to use like your Bluetooth headset as the microphone's audio, you can also choose that too. And all of that just from a link. That's it. Just a link you add as a browser source and boom, you have it. The only issue could be that link being different every single time. But the truth is, it's not something that you're supposed to be using all the time as like a full setup part of your stream. It's just something that, hey, if you have to do in a quick emergency, it'll take 5 minutes to set it up. And then boom, you grab your phone, you do whatever you have to do with it, come back and continue your live stream. Another thing that I like to use this option for is if I'm having like an impromptu new camera mount for the live stream. For example, if I'm playing like a simulator game with my sets of wheels and pedals, I'll have like a harness and I'll have my phone strapped to the harness so I can have like a chest mounted view. And of course, that's something that you can do with a webcam, for example, but your phone is wireless. A tablet will be wireless. If you're having an impromptu cooking stream, for example, but you don't want to lose all of your overlays and all of the channel points and chat functionalities, this is also a great example of how you can use it. So it's basically adding the element of IRL-ish, like the mobility of IRL streams without crossing the boundary of leaving your PC, right? You're still streaming from your computer. Anyways, if you have any ideas on how to creatively use this option, let me know in the comment section below. If live streaming solely from your phone is what you're looking for, I'm gonna have a video up right there. You can check it out. But in the meantime, I gotta say thank you so much for watching the video. Follow me on Twitch. Go out there, make me proud, get level. Out.